This video about how to install Master Key Hacky Pack. Bad luck on van. What I did, I took two halves of those brackets, locked them with the padlock, and then I already put them to the doors and marked the holes. They didn't come with the bolts, so I went to Home Depot and got some bolts, which is 5/16 diameter. Bolts, lock washers, bolts washers. And the spring washers, flat washers, spring washers, were under $10, 5/16, everything. I just went to Home Depot and brought this bracket. That's how I picked the bolts. And I took picture of every bolt and nut label for the check, for the checkout. But she was pretty cool, she recognized everything without any pictures. You see they have like wood style retaining squares on them. They're 1 inch long. 5/16, 1 inch long. And I marked the doors with red, whatever it is, red lipstick marker or whatever. And I'm gonna drill 5/16 holes. Here's it, here's this. And also I would like to remove the, it should fit. I would like to remove the lining from the door, which is plastic. I don't know if I need to unscrew this or not. Good question. Alright, I'll remove the lining just by prying it and popping out around perimeter, and I'll be back. These are two pieces that I removed from the door. That's what I left with, and I hope now it will just pry off. Okay, that's what it looks like. This is retaining clips and they went into these holes. Okay, have lots of shit in this door. Alright, now I think I will drill 5/16 holes. 6 holes, that's my job tonight. And the other door too. Got first hole done. It fits pretty good. Alright, I got 6 holes now. I'm gonna make this opening for the key to the right and the solid one to the left. So I need washer, nut, washer, nut, and spring washer, retaining washer. All right, I'm gonna install it here. That's how you do it. First you put flat washer, then spring washer, and then nut, and it will help nuts from unscrewing themselves. Let's pick proper socket wrench. 416, I think. Will do. Right? I have the nut here. So I'll just measure it. Say 10 millimeter, too small. Next set of keys I'll buy, it will be either in a box or in a sleeve, not in those plastic bullshit things. Hate them. I can't find 516, but this is 1/2 inch. Let's use 1/2 to tie them up. Nice thing about it, you don't need to retain them with another screw, with another wrench, because those wood bolts, they hold by the square. It probably sounds too loud on the video. I'll stop it and finish later. Alright, I tighten it all nicely. Good precision, no? That's how the lock works. You pull the cylinder out, and when you put it in a bracket, you close the cylinder. Right? Fits. No matter if there is blood or not, hockey puck will hold it. Now I'm gonna do this door. I have barn doors, not sliding ones. By the way, if you are interested in what parts I used, it's called Master Lock. It comes with two brackets. This is, I guess, part number. You can hit pause. Here's some kind of number too. Barcode. Here's some more numbers. That's it. More numbers. And here's the lock. I don't know who this seller is. It's from Amazon. Now I'm gonna put, look, I need to remove this too. And this. And I have a dilemma, should I put? And also I wanna say I bought 4 locks with the same key, with matching key. All 4 locks have 2 keys included, but all 4 have the same. Any keys open any lock, okay? That's how I picked. So I have used 1 key to all the doors. Initially I thought maybe I would put hacky pack on the front doors, but my partition doesn't have doors. I think it will be sufficient security wise. And now I don't know, should I put back retaining plastic or not? Because doors are storage compartments, you know? You can stick a lot of shit into door cavity. You can put a lot of stuff here. You can hook your bottle. Should I put it back or not? This is sharp. It's gonna puncture my hoses, probably, and extension cords. Okay, here, beside the retaining clips and Phillips screws, they also have handle with hex, okay? I don't know what the fuck. Why this confusion? Here is the barn door. There are some locks and latches and all kind of shit in it. So I figured it out. This is the height I'm gonna put it below it there. So now I'm gonna measure it and mark. The idea was not to shift it at all. Yeah, I think mostly okay. put brackets on. Start with the top. If you can buy extra lock on your bike locks with the same key, then it's great, because you see a lot of those hockey puck locks laying on the side of the road. People just put them in a bumper and forget about it. Maybe I'll run through to the corner. This is the bracket. Now I can use a ratchet wrench to tie them up. I hope the sound is not too disturbing on a video. one. Here I can't reach. Here I can't reach. Here. Gonna use snap wrench. One half, the same. Let's test it. Here's the lock. The problem, not even leveled. Lock doesn't fit too well. I think I have to lift the left one a little bit. Alright, I hit pause. So I removed the bracket and I think I will need to lift it a little bit, so I will just use the drill to kind of expand the hole vertically. I'm not sure it's doing its job, but thank you. I'm gonna leave this one alone. It has a little bit of play now. So I'm kind of applying pressure up and hope it will lift a little bit. Looks much better now. There you go. The sinkhole just expanded a little bit. Now I can put plastic back. Now the handle is hex. After this, need to probably get all the tools organized again, which is annoying but super important. This is a Phillips screw. Not even a bolt, it's just a fucking screw. This door is done. Better peace of mind. And these slugs are not bumpable, bump proof. You know, it's when you hit dummy key and hope it will unlock. And I have two more sets for these doors. And I don't really want to do it. It will look ugly. I don't know what to do. I will leave it as is for now. Alright, this was master lock pack, hockey pack locks on workbench installation video.